Welcome to English Guru YouTube channel. Please click the red subscribe button and press the bell icon to receive all notifications about my new video lectures. Good morning students, welcome back to English Guru YouTube channel. Today in this video lecture I will discuss 20 most important MCQs based on English literature for TGT, PGT and UGC NET exams. Okay, now let's begin. Question number 1. Roland Barthes is the author of one of the following texts. Option A, The Death of Tragedy. Option B, The Death of the Author. Option C, The Death of Literature. And option D, The Death of a Hero. Let me explain it. The Death of Tragedy is a 1961 work of literary criticism by George Steiner. The Death of the Author is a 1967 essay by the French literary critic and theorist Roland Barthes. The Death of Literature is a 1990 book by American literary critic and professor Alvin Kernan. The Death of a Hero is a World War I novel by Richard Eldington. It was his first novel published by Chatto and Windus in 1929 and thought to be partly autobiographical. So here the correct option will be B, The Death of the Author. Okay. Now question number 2. The Brothers Karamazov, the famous novel, was written by option A, Leo Tolstoy. Option B, Chekhov. Option C, Dostoevsky. And option D, Pushkin. So The Brothers Karamazov, the famous Russian novel published in November 1880, was written by Fyodor Dostoevsky. So here the correct option will be C, Dostoevsky. Okay. Now let's see question number 3. The Wasteland, the famous poem by T.S. Eliot, is divided into option A, 3 parts, option B, 4 parts, option C, 6 parts, and option D, 5 parts. So the poem The Wasteland by T.S. Eliot is divided into 5 sections: The Burial of the Dead, A Game of Chess, The Fire Sermon, Death by Water, and What Thunder Said. So here the correct option will be D, 5 parts. Okay. Now let's talk about question number 4. Who of the following said that Milton belongs to the Devil's Party without knowing it? Option A, William Blake. Option B, William Empson. Option C, C.S. Lewis. And option D, Frank Kermode. So it was William Blake who observed that Milton belonged to the Devil's Party without knowing it. The remark implies that Milton unconsciously glorified Satan, specially in Book First of Paradise Lost. Here the correct option will be A, William Blake. Now let's switch over to question number 5. Strophe, antistrophe and epode form a 3-part structure in option A, a Greek ode, option B, a classic ode, option C, a medieval ode, and option D, a Petrarchan sonnet. So an ode is a type of lyrical stanza. It is an elaborately structured poem praising or glorifying an event or individual, describing nature intellectually as well as emotionally. A classic ode is structured in 3 major parts: the strophe, the antistrophe, and the epode. Here the correct option will be B, a classic ode. Alright. Now question number 6. The well-wrought urn is written by option A, René Wellek, option B, William K. Wimsett, option C, Clint Brooks, and option D, Terry Eagleton. Let me explain it. The well-wrought urn studies in the structure of poetry published in 1947 is a collection of essays by Clint Brooks. It is considered a seminal text in the new critical school of literary criticism. The title contains an allusion to the fourth stanza of John Donne's poem, The Canonization, which is the primary subject of the first chapter of the book. Here correct option will be C, Clint Brooks. Alright, now let's see question number 7. The soul of tragedy, according to Aristotle, is option A, character, option B, thought, option C, spectacle, and option D, plot. Let me explain it. In the Poetics, Aristotle compares tragedy to such other metrical forms as comedy and epic. According to him, the principal element in the structure of tragedy is not character but plot. Most important of all, Aristotle said, is the structure of the incidents. For tragedy is an imitation not of men but of an action and of life, and life consists in action, and its end is mode of action, not a quality. Aristotle considered the plot to be the soul of a tragedy, with character in second place. Here the correct option will be D, plot. The soul of tragedy, according to Aristotle, is plot. Okay, now let's see next question. Question number 8. The author of The Hungry Tide is option A, Amitav Ghosh, option B, Vikram Seth, option C, Shobha Day, and option D, Upamanyu Chatterjee. So, The Hungry Tide 2004 is the sixth novel by Indian-born author Amitav Ghosh. It won the Hutch Crossword Book Award for Fiction in 2004. Here, correct option will be A, Amitav Ghosh. Okay. Now, question number 9. The woman character who is an artist by profession in Virginia Woolf's To the Lighthouse is option A, Mrs. Ramsey, option B, Lily Briscoe, option C, Mrs. Dalloway, and option D, Miriam. Let me explain it. Lily Briscoe is a fictional character, painter, and one of the central characters in the novel To the Lighthouse, published in 1927 by Virginia Woolf. Lily represents Woolf's ideal artist who mingles masculine rationality with feminine sympathy. Here correct option will be B, Lily Briscoe. Okay. Now, question number 10. The poet who described poetry as inspired mathematics is option A, T.S. Eliot, option B, G.M. Hopkins, option C, Ezra Pound, and option D, W.B. Yeats. So, Ezra Pound, born on October 30, 1885, and died on November 1, 1972, an American expatriate, poet, musician, and critic who was a major figure of the modernist movement in early to mid 20th century poetry, described poetry as a sort of inspired mathematics. So, your correct option will be C, Ezra Pound. The poet Ezra Pound described poetry as inspired mathematics. Alright. Now, question number 11. The posthumously published novel of Jane Austen is option A, Sense and Sensibility, option B, Mansfield Park, option C, Emma, and option D, Northanger Abbey. Let me explain it. Jane Austen published four novels during her lifetime. Sense and Sensibility, published in 1811, Pride and Prejudice, published in 1813, Mansfield Park, published in 1814, and Emma, published in 1815. Northanger Abbey was the first of Jane Austen's novel to be completed for publication in 1803. However, it was not published until after her death in 1817, so the novel Northanger Abbey is posthumously published novel of Jane Austen. Here correct option will be D, Northanger Abbey. Alright. Now question number 12. Carlyle's sorter resortus means option A, the tailor retailered, option B, I know not where, option C, Satan's story retold, and option D, a set of elegant clothes. So sorter resortus, meaning the tailor retailered, is an 1836 novel by Thomas Carlyle, first published as a serial in Fraser's Magazine in November 1833 to August 1834. So your correct option will be A, the tailor retailered. Now question number 13. The theater of cruelty is associated with option A, Grotowski, option B, Antonin Artaud, option C, Brecht, option D, Ionesco. The theater of cruelty is a form of theater generally associated with the playwright, actor, essayist and theorist Antonin Artaud. So your correct option will be B, Antonin Artaud. The theater of cruelty is associated with Antonin Artaud. All right. Now let's switch over to question number 14. Using the expression crown for the monarchy is an example of option A, hyperbole, option B, personification, option C, metonymy, and option D, synecdoche. So describing a monarch as the crown or business people as suits is metonymy. The expression the pen is mightier than the sword uses metonymy twice. The pen refers to writing while the sword refers to war. So your correct option will be C, metonymy. Now question number 15. The concept of arch writing is developed by option A, Foucault, option B, Barthes, option C, G.C. Spivak, Gayatri Chakravarti Spivak, option D, Derrida. So arch writing is a term used by French philosopher Jacques Derrida in his attempt to reorient the relationship between speech and writing. Arch writing is an original form of language which is not derived from speech. Here correct option will be D, Derrida. The concept of arch writing is developed by Derrida. Alright. Now let's see question number 16. Table Talk is a collection of essays by option A, Hazlitt, option B, Lamb, option C, Hunt, and option D, Edison. So the Table Talk is a collection of essays by the English cultural critic and social commentator William Hazlitt. It was originally published as two volumes, the first of which appeared in April 1821. The second volume was completed on 7th March 1822. Your correct option will be A, Hazlitt. Now question number 17. Dr. Johnson's Dictionary of the English Language was published in the year option A, 1757, option B, 1756, option C, 1755, and option D, 1758. A dictionary of the English language written by Samuel Johnson was published on 15th April 1755. So your correct option will be C, 1755. Now question number 18. Willy Loman is a character in option A, A Doll's House, option B, The Cherry Orchard, option C, Waiting for Godot, and option D, Death of a Salesman. So William Willy Loman is a fictional character and the protagonist of Arthur Miller's 1949 classic play Death of a Salesman. Here correct option will be T, death of a salesman. Okay. Now let's talk about question number 19. Which of the following plays was written by Samuel Beckett? Option A, Endgame. Option B, A Doll's House. Option C, Volpone. And option D, Mother Courage and Her Children. So Endgame, published in 1957, is one act play by Samuel Beckett. A Doll's House, published in 1879, is a three act play written by Henrik Ibsen. Volpone, published in 1606, is a comedy play by English playwright Ben Jonson. Mother Courage and Her Children is a play written in 1939 and published in 1941 by the German dramatist and poet Bertolt Brecht, with significant contributions from Margaret Stephen. Here the correct option will be A, Endgame. The play Endgame was written by Samuel Beckett. Now let's see question number 20. Who wrote A Tiger Does Not Proclaim Its Tigritude? Option A, Anne Gugge. Option B, Wole Soyinka. Option C, H.B. And option D, Derek Walcott. Let me explain it. Anki Wonde Oluwole Babutunde Soyinka, known as Wole Soyinka, born on 13 July 1934, is a Nigerian playwright, poet, novelist, essayist, and pro-democracy activist. In 1986, he became the first African winner of the Nobel Prize for Literature. A Tiger Does Not Proclaim His Tigritude, He Pounces, has been quoted by Wole Soyinka. So here the correct option will be B, Wole Soyinka. That's the end of my video lecture. I hope you would have been benefited through this video lecture. One thing I would like to mention here is that if you have not subscribed my channel till date, please subscribe by clicking the red subscribe button and also press the bell icon so that you may get notification regarding my upcoming video lectures. Thanks for watching. Good luck.